Hi, this video provides a quick overview on how to use App Puzzle to create a flip video for your flip classroom. First, you want to point your browser to apppuzzle.com. Next, you want to go to sign up as a teacher. So choose teacher. And if you have an App Model teacher account, you can click on login with App Model. But first, you want to make sureyour App Model account, you are logging as a teacher. Make sure you're not logging as a student. After you choose logging with App Model, it will go look for your App Model credential and then allow you to log in. Okay, next, to create a new video, you want to first create a classroom so you can assign this video to the class. So I'm going to go toClick on My Classes and choose Add Class. From here, I'm going to choose a class name. Now click Save. So you have a classroom created. Now you can see here are my classes. Now I'm going to click on My Content and click on Create a New Video.You cannot create a video using App Puzzle, but you can search for YouTube video or Khan Academy video or different sources from the left menu and a number of different sources. So I'm going to choose a video from YouTube that I have created. So I'm going to post the link there and click on the magnifying glass to search for that video. So this is the video on flip learning that I had created.And upload it to YouTube. So now, if it's not a video of my own without narration, I can add audio track of my own, or I can click on this to add audio notes. My goal is to just create question quizzes that embedded in the video. Okay, so I'm gonna click on question mark directly, and I'm gonna click the play the video a little bit.
Hi, this video.
Okay, now I know it's working. So, yeah, I usually like to have a warm-up question. So you can click on the question mark here below the screen, the video, and add your first question. You can create open question where they can type in a short answer or a test where it's a multiple choice. You can add more answers so they have more than two choices. Or a comment.For them to share. I'm going to use open and ask. Okay, so I want to know the learner's experience in creating flip video. So now I'm done, click on done. Then you're going to show me what the question will look like and the student can answer here. So once I'm happy with this, I can click continue.
A quick overview of flip
and now the video continues playing. So I can let it run until the next point I want to ask question, or I can drag the slider to where I may want to insert the next question. And here I can ask a multiple choice question. And I can add an answer. Okay, when I'm done, I click on done, and then I can preview the question, and I can click continue, so it will play the video, and then from here, I can listen to the video again, or move fast forward to where I want to ask the next question. So one at the beginning, one in the middle, one at the end, sounds good. So I'm going to click on question mark to add another question, or you can make a comment.So without grading. Okay, now I'm done with this. So I'm going to click on done. And you can see I have three questions embedded in this video. I can preview by click on the play button or click done. And now this is the title of the video. And I can use tab to allow me to look for my video in the future easily. Okay, there are a few more suggested tags. So I'm going to save and exit. And next, he asked me, where do I want to put this class so students in this class can view it? You can have same video in multiple classes. Then you don't have to place it in different class folder separately. So I'm going to just put it on 500 and 561 for now. You can prevent skipping, so they had to watch the video and answer the question, or you can uncheck this so they can skip to where they want to watch instead of going through the whole thing again. Okay, so now I'm going to click on Save Assignment. Okay, next I can go to my classes. So on CID 500, there's this assignment being assigned. I can put a due date, and I can also look at 561, and click on this button will allow you to copy the URL to share with a student, or you can copy the embedded code to share with your student. And this is, you can copy the URL to share this video with the class and post it to Edmodo. And right now there's no students, so I cannot see the progress. Let me go to a class that I have a list of students. So from here, it show me, you can see if a student has responded to this, answer the question in this video. Later, you can retrieve your video by going to My Content, and you will see a list of video that you have created. And on the video, below the video, there's a wheel. You can go back to edit the video, but you will lose the assignment. That's okay. If this video hasn't been viewed by your students, that's okay. If not, you don't want to do that. Or you can share the video to anyone. Well, you can share this video with anyone, but their responses won't be recorded. Also, when your student watch the video, they can log in with the Edmodo credential, so they don't have to create a separate login account to watch the video. And that's it, how you create a flip video using Edpuzzle.